So am I audible?
Yes, Sanjay.
Yeah, thank you. And first we will discuss about copy and move command. First we will discuss about copy, then we will discuss about the move command, then we will discuss about vir vim editor commands. So by using the copy command, you can copy a file, either you can copy a file or directory. You can copy a file or directory to one location to other location. Okay, to one location to other location. So see, here I have a file. So this is the Linux command prompt. Here I have a file. Example, I'm creating a file by using the cat command. You can create a file by using the cat command, either touch command, either vi command also. Let it be complete. First of all, see, we can create a file by using the cat, either by using the touch, by using the vim command. First, by using the cat command, I am creating a file. For example, file name is, here file name is dba. Just see how to enter the data here only. I'm enter, this is dba file. If you want to save the information into the file, just you have to press Control D. Control D is save and exit. Now I have to check that file is created or not. How to check that one? By using ls command. So this is the file, I'm right. And see, in this file, what is the information is available? You can, that means we can find out file structure again by using the cat command. See, so cat, then file name is dba. Am I right? But you should remember, all of you, whenever we want to create a file, first we have to know where we are creating the file. That means which location. By using pwd command, we can find out which location you are creating a file. For example, I am creating a file slash root. So see, I want to copy a file. See, what is the information as available in this file? I want to copy into the another file. Very simple, cp command. Cp means copy command. Remember, cp means copy command. So what I want to copy? See, I want to copy dba file information. Where I want to copy? In the same location. In the same location, that means in slash root only. See, whenever we want to copy a file, just you have to mention the file name is, file name is db. That means what we have information in the dba file, it is copy into the dba file. Here there is no dba file, you should remember, there is no dba file. Automatically it will be created. Enter. Then we can check it. So we have a dba file. What you have information in the dba file, the same information is available in db. Just see how to open that one. Cat dba, then cat db. So this is the dba file under dba file. This is the dba file under db file. That means by using the copy command, you can copy a information, either file, you know, one location to another location. Am I right? That means you can copy. We have a method is there. We have a relative method, relative and absolute method is there. Relative means in the same location. We want to copy the file, you know, into the same location. Into the same location, you can use copy, okay, na, cp then file name, then destination name. Okay. But when we are using the absolute path, note, so remember, in copy command, we are not using root. That means this symbol we are not using, root directory we are not using. In the absolute path, that means, so here we are using, you are using root. That means this one we are using. See, this is the same location, I'm right? Slash root. In the same location, you don't want to use this symbol. Whenever we want to copy one location to another location, one location to another location, okay, then we can use this symbol. When we can use this symbol, I will explain later. Just a minute. See, for example, I have a directory. So directory name is project. We can check it, that directory is available or not. This is the directory, am I right? So it is available or not, we can check it. Okay, now. So by using ls command, yes. In this directory, do you have any files or directories? How you can check it, that one? By using ls space -r capital R, then we can give the directory name is project. Do you have any file? No. I want to copy a file. What is the file? DBA file. Where I want to copy? I want to copy under the directory. The directory name is project. The directory name is project. See, the DBA file will be going to copy under the project directory. Just you have to give the enter. Successfully, the file has been moved into the project directory. How you can check it, that one? Ls space capital R, then project directory. Right? And if you want to copy the multiple files, if you want to copy, for example, see, I have a files 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. I have a files 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But those files I want to copy under the project directory. So what we have to do? Copy. Then 1, 2, 3, then 4, then 5. Where I have to copy? Under the project directory. Just we have to give the command ls space -r capital R. Then we can give the project directory name. Even if we have the directory, for example, I have this directory. The directory is Unix. So where is available Unix? Slash root. Where is available directory? Slash root, then directory. This project, am I right? So now I want to copy that cp. I want to copy Unix directory into project directory. Remember, I want to copy Unix directory under project directory. Just we are using the copy command. Then enter. Okay. So you are getting one error. Slash R. Oh, sorry. -rb. Not suspect means. See, recursively I want to copy R. Then Unix into the project directory. -r means recursively. So now you can check it. Under the project directory, okay, now what how the information here? We can find. This is the relative part. This is the relative part. Very, very simple, ma. The relative part means in the same location we can copy the file or directory. In absolute path means, for example, see, so I am in B directory. Where I am in? I am in root directory here. How to get the root directory? For example, before I am in class. Now I want to enter into the root directory. Very simple. CD means change the directory. Where I want to enter the root directory? Just we have to press around. Then enter. So we can. Please, please. I think that someone has. Sunil, please, Sunil, unmute your audio.
Manji, you can unmute yourself. Actually, I muted all the people.
Okay, Anna. See, if you have any doubt, please ask me. Anyone, no problem. I will explain clearly. But in meanwhile, please, all of you should unmute your voice. I mean, audio only. See, first, I'm explain here. So copy command, and that copy command relative path I was explained. What is the relative path? You can copy a file either directory into the same location, into the same location. Okay. For example, if you want to use the absolute path, how you can use the absolute path? Absolute path. Okay, no? So you can copy a file either directory, file or directory into the other location. Okay. Example, my file is available cat. My file is available. Sorry, I am creating one file data. So cat, then data. See, we are getting one error. Data is a directory. That means already you have a data directory. So I'm creating another one. It's like Oracle. So cursor is waiting here only. Just you have to type the information. Okay, I'm typing. So this is Oracle database project file. Then Control D, 7 exit. We can find out by using the ls command that file is created or not. Yes, successfully. So where you have create a file. So PWD means present working directory. Where ma? You have created a file under slash root. That means here you have created, am I right? Sorry. Here you have created, the file name is Oracle. But I want to copy a file into other location. That means under the slash mnt. Okay, na? Under the slash mnt, I want to create project file. Sorry. I want to create project directory. Remember, okay. So am I audible? Hello?
Yeah.
Thank you. Because here we have a power cut, that's why we didn't get internet connection. Again, I'm connecting through my mobile network. So please hold the line. Just a minute, I want to check it, which IP address is available in this my system. NumCLI connections of ENS160. If config ENS160 and yes. So where I was create the file under the root directory, am right? What is the file name? Varagil. Where I want to create the directory under the /mnt. First we have to check the directory is available or not under the /mnt. How you can check it that one? Remember, ls/mnt. Do you have the project directory? No. We need to create that one. Mkdir. Okay, na. What I want to create directory, project directory, where I want to create /mnt. I want to create a project directory under the /mnt. Am I right? Now you can check it. ls/mnt. Yes, we have a project directory. See, my file is available root directory. Okay, na. My directory is available /mnt. Now I want to copy this file into this directory. Now I want to copy this file under this directory. So very simple. Just we can use the copy command. So where you are working, where we are working, just we have to find out that one also. /root. See here, copy /root. Sorry, root. Then file name is Varagil. Where I want to copy that one /mnt. Then what is the project? What is the directory name? Project. Then enter. See, that meaning is we are copying a file. Okay, into either under project directory where it is available under the /mnt. Okay, and now I want to check it that one by using ls/mnt, then /project. Yes, your file is available successfully. For example, if we have the directories and subdirectories, for example, mkdir-p, I want to create x, y, z directories like x, comma, y, comma, z directories. Okay, now I have a directory. The directory is x, y, z directory. Where I was creating the XYZ directory and the root directory. We can find out that one XYZ directory. Okay. See, now what are the subdirectories are available under the XY directory? We can find out that one. So we can find out that one. See, LS capital R, then XYZ directory. We have a x comma y comma z directories are available. So see, this is the x, y, z directory. Where I want to move that one? Either copy that one. I want to copy. I want to copy x, y, z directory into /mnt under the project directory. So I am getting like this error. Just you have to use the -r and a recursible. Just I am using here -r. -r means recursible. Now you can check it. So the directory is available or not available or not under the project directory. How? /mnt, then project. We have a XYZ directory. So always should be remember in the relevant path, relative path, we are not using the, okay, now. So root directory, but in the absolute path, definitely we have to use the root directory. Okay. How to check the present working directory?